If you've ever started a project and you've got a nice sound here and you thought, gee, that's a lovely sound, boop, and the perfect thing that to add to this perfect song that I've created would be a nice delay. So then you thought, okay, that's easy. I'll click the plus sign, go to Bitwig, and then there's three delays to choose from. And well, if you're like me, you thought, well, I know math, and Delay-4 is at least twice as good as Delay-2, and probably four times better than Delay-1. So you thought, okay, you know, this is such a special and unique and fantastically complex song, I think I'll go for the Delay-4. So you give that a click, click, all right, and then it's, right? Like, I wanted a delay, not the Starship Enterprise. What the hell is that? Yeah, me too. So if you could go ahead and make a video and explain just how the hell you use this thing, that would be great. Thanks. I'm kidding. I'm just kidding. That's what the whole point of this video is about. Let's start the show. So one would certainly be forgiven for loading up a Delay-4, seeing all this crap, and then going, no, and going right back to the Delay-2, because that's easy. That's a comfortable place. It's very well laid out, right? You got your left speaker and your right speaker, and it's like, well, which 16th note of the bar do I feel like repeating the original sound on? And, you know, you got some stuff here. You got your filters, very, very basic stuff, you know, feedback effects, and it's comfortable. But you can't do that your whole life, right? You can't live your whole life in the shadow of the Delay-4, especially because it's got such cool stuff going on inside of it. And you know, it's definitely worth a little investigation here. So before we get into that, let me show you what I've done. I've gone to my browser, I've gone to samples, and I've went into Joe Mock's basics there, and I took snare 82-02, and I just threw it in there. That's it, okay? And I zoomed in, right, because I just want a single bar, basically, on my screen. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's just one bar. It's really big looking, and that's just because I zoomed in, okay? And this is what the sample sounds like. And you'll get familiar with that in a sec. I'm going to take the tempo down to 40, I believe. And there's a good reason for that. And lastly, I'm just going to change the grid to 16th notes. And again, I'll explain why I'm doing that right now. Okay, so if we look at the Delay-4, let's break it down. Okay, don't look at it. Don't look at the zoomed out version of this. It can be confusing and a little intimidating. Just look at how there's one row that goes straight across there. Okay, there should be little lines that separate this, just so that your eye is directed to the flow of it for now. Okay, and so in here you can see the timing, which is set to 16th notes. I know that because it says 1 out of 16. And that's why I tuned my grid to be on 16th notes. So really simply, if I want a delay so that it plays the original and then it plays another copy of that sound on the next 16th note, which would be right here, that's simple. I can just turn up number 1. And because that's on 1/16th note, what that's saying is after you play the original, play another repeat of that sound 1/16th note later. So what you'll get is a boop, boop. Okay, let's listen. Right, just as we expected. So that's pretty simple, right? And now if I want, if I turn up the number 2, I'm saying play the original, play the original again a 16th note later, right? Because we have 1 still turned up, and then play another copy of that sound 2/16th notes later, because we turned up number 2 and this is set to 2/16th notes, right? So this is basically saying that you want to play that, repeat the sound 2/16th notes after the original. So now we should get boop, boop, boop. Right, exactly as we expected. And of course with 3 and with 4. Right, okay, and just to be clear, even when you're on 4, you're saying I want you to play a copy or a repeat of that sound 4/16th notes after the original. For example, if I turn all these down and I want to play the way I have this set is I want to play the original. And then after the original's played, I want to play another copy of it 4/16th notes later. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And you should hear one right here. Let's watch. Yeah, exactly. So pretty simple, right? Now, I think a lot of the confusion comes from this feed, this the feeding trough. They should have called it the feeding trough. That's so cool. No, they shouldn't have. That's stupid. Never mind. And basically, this is exactly the same thing, okay? So if I have the way I have it set right now, if you remember, I'm playing the original and then I'm playing it again 1/16th note later. Well, maybe I turn up number 2, okay? So what that's saying is play the original, play it a 16th note later, and then play it another 16th note after number 2 goes. So we should hear do, 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 okay? Does that make any sense to you at all? Let me turn this down and let's turn up 2. Right. So we've gone over that. You know how that's working. Now, if I turn up 2, I'm basically adding whatever this value is to play after this. So if this is set to 2/16th notes, I'm saying play it again after another 16th note. And I've done that by saying, well, I want to send 1 over to 2. Okay. So it's literally the same as me turning this down, but turning that up. And I'll show you. Okay. So let's listen. Right. Now, let me turn this down and this up. No difference. Right. And the reason is because number 3 is going to play a 16th note after number 2. Right. And if I do this again, it's going to play a 16th note after number 2. Okay. And so it's as simple as that. But I can feel your brains just seething at all the infinite amounts of combinations that you can really do inside this thing. And I feel it too, man. It's like think about how you can set all these differently and like you can bust them all over to themselves. Like you can get the most insane kind of delays, like the most off time, weirdest, craziest delays out of this. Okay, but let's just keep it simple for now. Okay, if you don't want to time it to 16th notes, you can just do it by seconds. And that's pretty simple. But the cool thing is you can choose, like, I want this one to be in 16th notes, but I want this one to be in seconds. So now if I turn this up and turn that up, what's going to happen is it's going to play the original and then play a repeat 1/16th note later and then play a repeat 1 second later. And then because I fed this one to number 2, it's going to play a repeat 1/16th note after this 1 second, which is just weird, right? Right? And that's in like given my tempo and stuff, that's just so strange. But it's just super cool that you can do that kind of stuff. Okay, moving along. This is your offset. Okay, so you can offset it. What is it? Up to 33.33. You can set it off up to a third, basically. And that's just you're basically it's not exactly a perfect 16th note. It's 1.3/16th notes at that point, and you can just set it so it's a little off time, and it's nothing more than that. Okay, don't get hung up on this guy. It's just if you want to swing something or you know play around with it, it's pretty cool. And yeah, that's all it does. You got your filters here, and that's basically this is not filtering your original sound. For example, if I turn this down, okay, I'm gonna turn that off. What's happening is it's playing the original unaffected, just the way it is, and then the repeats are going through a filter. That's why it sounds a little different. Listen. Right? It sounds a little muffled. Yeah. Let's just bring that back up to 20K. Hey. 20K. Okay. So now you have these effects things right here and right there. And let's load up, let's see, something that compounds on, like a pitch shifter. Okay, and I'm just going to crank up the pitch shift. And let's observe what happens when it's in the effects loop. Is it an effects loop? Effects chain? Whatever, same thing, really. Okay, so let's have a listen. Okay, so it plays the original unaffected, and then it plays the pitched up version, right? The, what is it, 12 semitones, so it's an octave higher. Okay? And so maybe we send that over to 2. Right. Okay, so now let's even turn this one up and this one down. So you should just hear this repeat a bunch of times because I'm feeding this back into itself. Because I'm telling it, play, when this is off, I'm saying play the original and then play a repeat a 16th note later using this effect. And then when I turn this up, it's like play it another 16th note later and another 16th note later, right? It's like stop hitting yourself. Listen. You can turn it all the way up and it'll just do that forever. Right? Okay. All right. That's enough of that. Okay. Now you're thinking, let's put this in here and let's hear it again. And you're thinking, well, that's literally just zero difference between the two of those. And that's not actually true because this one is going to play that sound. It's going to just put the original through this effect each time and it's just looping it. So it's going boop, 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 right? This one, it's feeding that sound back in. So it's playing the original and then the original is going through here and whatever sound comes out of that, which is an octave up, is getting refed into there. It goes up another octave and another octave. So let's turn this up and listen. Right? And it'll just go to infinity. Until all the dogs in the world hate you. And so that's super cool. Because think about it, it's compounding whatever effect is in here. And that's the nature of feedback effects, really, is that they compound. They change the sound, and then that sound, whatever, however it's been changed, gets fed back in, and over and over and over. And that's the fundamental difference between putting it in the feedback effects and or putting it in this one right here, the effects loop, okay? Where this one's just gonna play the original sample through there, and this one is going to compound that effect over and over and over and over, okay? So that's super cool, and I'm sure you can think of a million ways to use that. Like if you put it through a filter and a reverb, for example, it gets like further away in the distance. You can put a pan tool on it, and it gets slowly further into the left speaker. And that kind of segues us right into this this output / pan tool. And it's really simple. It's how loud is the signal coming through here and which speaker is it in? Is it in my left speaker, in my right speaker, or directly in the center? And is it really freaking loud? Is it off? Minus infinity, that's bizarre, right? That they would add minus infinity when you can just go like that. Actually, no, there's a use for that because you might want that delay time. I don't know, man. Anyway, -6. Okay, and then you have your effects here, which is just, it's basically the same as adding it right there. It's just the effects for the overall delay 4. Okay? All right. I think that does it. Feed is basically, well, look, it says right there, the amplitude of the signal, which is fed back into itself. So this is the overall volume for all of these guys right there, okay? Don't get hung up on that just because it's called feed, but it's not in the feeding trough. It's kind of outside there, right? It's like the one little piglet that ran off. No, that doesn't apply. Never mind. That was also stupid. And then your mix. Am I hearing only the original sound or only the sounds that come after the original, right? So if I have this in the center, we get 2 repeats. If I put it on all the way to the right, we don't even hear the original. Right? If I put all the way to the left, we don't hear the delay. Right in the center, we get the effect. Okay, I hope that clears it up a little bit for you. Definitely, if you have questions, leave them below the video. If you have suggestions for future videos, I would love to hear those right about now, because it's hard for me to know what you guys want to know without your feedback, and I just love talking to you guys. And you can do that a couple ways. You can comment down below the video. You can click right here and go to my Facebook, the Facebook for the Vaan's Bitwig tutorials that I've set up for you, and we can have chats on there. We have some pretty interesting discussions happening there. You could click about, and you can go down and email me if that's what you so choose. Okay. All right, guys, I hope that helped you out. Be good to each other. Have a good time. Have a good night, and keep wigging out on Bitwig Studio. Ciao.